Hey everyone, welcome back. My name's dustinkreis, and welcome to what's going to be the fuck all of game discussions on this channel. Today we're going to talk about a game called Demon's Souls, brought to us by Atlas and From Software. And if you're a longtime viewer of this channel, you're going to know that this series, Demon's Souls, Dark Souls, and Dark Souls 2, has not been one of my favorites over the years. Over the last year. It's just, I don't know. You can see the description down below, what I decided to put as the video's description. There you go. I decided to play Demon's Souls to try to give the series one last shot. I bought this back when I got my PS3. I don't know how many years ago that's been, because everyone was talking about it, and I thought I'd give it a go, played it, and had a good, not almost say a good time with it, but enjoyed it well enough. But got to a point where I just could not get past it, and decided to put it away. Cut to, sometime last year, I don't remember exactly when the game came out, everyone was getting hyped up for Dark Souls 2 coming out. And I got sort of wrapped up in that hype a little bit as well, and picked up the game. And again, same thing with Demon's Souls. If I didn't already say that, I might not have. I played as a melee character, and in Dark Souls 2, played as a melee character as well, and was just infuriated beyond all belief, so much so that I traded the game in, deleted the save off of my PS3, and just swore up and down that I would never play another Souls game. Then an interesting thing happened, a very unrelated thing that made me rethink this stance. I played a game on the Vita, it was just released here not too long ago, called Brandish, and I don't know why. I don't know what the exact thing was, but for some reason, Brandish made me think, I kind of want to give this series one last shot. Give it one last try to make a positive impression on me. And I have never gotten rid of my copy of Demon's Souls, because this thing is, it's not even worth trading in anymore. So I never got rid of it. So I thought, I already have that game. I don't have to sink any more money into this series since I already own it. Let's just throw it in and give it one last try. And, I have been helped on this journey by several people, and I'm going to start mentioning names that have already been said on this channel ad nauseum. So if you get sick at that kind of thing, you might want to turn the video off. First and foremost, Steven has always kind of been in the background, kind of secretly wanting me to go back to Souls, and probably play Diablo 2. Who knows? I don't know. I got to talk about him. Danny Devil May Pie was also very instrumental in getting me back in the series. He and the next guy I'm going to mention kind of talked me through it in the early stages. But the next guy, really, really, I have to give a huge shout out to, because without him, I probably would not have finished this game, and that is Corn Muffin. He really was talking me through it, giving me a lot of tips and pointers, and even came in and saved my bacon. There we go. That's what I was going to say. Saved my bacon a couple times. He helped me fight the man-eater, which basically means he distracted them, and I was able to throw some spells at the man-eater and deal some damage. He also came in and helped me get through the Valley of Defilement, which is probably the most aggravating stage out of all the stages in that game. Like, the Valley of Defilement, I just fuck that entire area. Just fuck it. He also, unbeknownst to me, when we were getting ready to fight, what was her name? Saint Astria. Basically, he just bow sniped it for me, and I was like, "Oh, that was rather unsatisfying." But as I moved through the stage and saw the layout of the stage and the fact that I hadn't beat her little crony somewhere else in the stage, he basically said it was going to be suicide, and I would be stuck there for a while. So, you know, it propelled me through the game, got me through the game, and also showed me that in the Souls series, bows are just ridiculously overpowered, just phenomenally overpowered. As long as you have the strength to use them, which I did not, because I was using a royal class, which yes, it is the quote unquote easy mode, but fuck off. It got me through the game. I played the game, and guess what? I actually enjoyed the game playing as a royal. So if you want to make fun of me for playing as royalty, that's fine, but I'm not going to listen to you because I enjoyed my time with Demon Souls. Yes, that is right. You can read the description down below. I'm eating crow. I actually enjoyed my time with Demon Souls. Now, do I think the Souls series is the greatest game, the greatest series of games ever made? No, absolutely not. I still have a lot of problems with the series. Mainly the fact that I can press buttons on the controller and the character just does nothing. I mean, that's just a problem for the first Demon Souls. I don't know. But there's been several times, you know, I wasn't even frantically pressing the button. I was just, you know, I got the enemy Z-targeted, as we'll call it, because, you know, Zelda made it that way. And I was getting ready, I pushed the button, held it in, and the guy just stood there. So I don't know if that's a behind-the-scenes dice roll, because Joe and I were kind of talking about behind-the-scenes dice rolls in this game. Or if it's just an unresponsiveness of the game. I'm going to go ahead and say unresponsiveness of the game. And that happened quite a bit. I mean, it's a little thing, and as long as you keep moving, it's not a big deal. But if I press that button, I fucking want the spell to happen, you know. So there are still things about the series I don't like. I don't like that if you make basically one mistake, you're just dead. And I died a lot in this game. Yeah, playing as a sort of a mage ranged character, I had a lot more fun because, you know, I wasn't getting surrounded by multiple enemies, and I could just sit back and, you know, just enjoy the exploration, enjoy the world, enjoy the lore. And that's what I wanted out of the game. I didn't want these tense, you know, 20-minute long melee fights that I had in Dark Souls 2. I wanted to just be able to see the world, enjoy the story, what I got of it, because we'll talk about that when we get to the storyline. And basically just enjoy the game how I wanted to enjoy it. So, big thank you to those three people that I mentioned, especially Joe, because he took it's one thing to talk to me about the game and try to give me tips and stuff, but to actually take time out of your day to help me through a stage, time for me personally, time is like the most precious thing I have. So, for Joe to do that, you made me enjoy the series, or made me enjoy this game. Got me through the hard parts that I just couldn't get through myself, and I got to enjoy the rest of it by myself. And really, I mean, other than the Maneater and the Valley of Defilement, I did this game by myself. So, you know, there is the thing where, you can co-op and have somebody just kind of drag you through the game. No, I did about 80%, 80 to 90% of the game by myself. So I do feel that sort of sense of accomplishment, even though a couple of the enemies I just cheesed. Like the blue dragon, I sprinted up those steps, got underneath of him, and just fire sprayed him to death. King Alaunt, I used the poison cloud trick. And hey, if the game lets you do that, Alex, return to mother base. I'm going to say another name, so if you're going to vomit, you might want to get a bucket handy. Alex, return to mother base, said there is no... How do you word it? Shit. Basically, there's no cheap way to kill a boss. If there's an exploit, use it in the game. So I read about the Poison Cloud exploit and just cheesed a lot. I didn't care. And I beat the game. I got to see the end. So anyway, let's go ahead and I've enough preface. Let's talk about this game and let's talk about the world and the storyline of Demon's Souls. And it presents the story in a rather interesting way, which is we're used to RPGs doing cutscenes and explaining everything to us. The Souls series, and this is part of the reason why I didn't like Dark Souls, because I didn't understand exactly what was going on. It tells the story a bit differently. It's more about sort of observing the world and making inferences. Item descriptions and NPCs kind of telling you what's going on. There's no real big cutscenes that tell the storyline. You just kind of gotta, you know, take the world in and get the storyline that way. That's really all you can do, because it doesn't tell a traditional narrative A to B, you know. It kind of just drops you in this world and lets you figure out what's going on in Boletaria, which is this kingdom. But the basic gist of the storyline is this king named Alaunt started to abuse soul power to gain power and expand his kingdom. And he abused it so much that he awoke this old demon called the Old One and basically ushered in the apocalypse for his kingdom. And you are a lone soldier, depending on what class, because I have looked up some stuff, like some wikis on the storyline. And depending on what class, you come from a different area of Boletaria or the neighboring kingdom, Latvia? I don't remember the name. Basically you set out to try to stop the Old One from destroying the world. You know, kind of a traditional thing. Stop the big monster from destroying the world. There you go. But, you know, you come across all these different characters and they kind of give you little snippets of the storyline, but it's really up to you to kind of piece it together or do what I do and just go online and find a wiki. You know, people replay these games over and over again and, you know, they probably piece together the story for themselves. For me, I got all this behind me. And you guys can't see it, but all this along this wall here, a lot of stuff to play. So I can't go back and, you know, play Demon's Souls over and over and over and over and over again. I got to get through all this backlog, or otherwise, what's the point, you know? So going to a wiki and figuring out what's actually going on in the game is fine enough for me. The world it presents, I do really like the world. And I said that kind of back in my... I never did a Dark Souls 2 discussion video. I just kind of did a video where I, you know, kind of ranted against the game. I do like the world. And I do like the things that the game presents. I just, you know, I don't like what... I didn't like at the time what you had to do to get through that. To see the next beautiful vista or to see the next cool thing, you know. It was such a slog. But now with, you know, some idea of what to do in these games and some pointers, you know, maybe a revisit, who knows. Gameplay, you've probably heard countless people talk about this game. It is a fucking challenging ass game. There's no way around it. It's just hard. And I can't think of a game. Except maybe like back in the day with like the Mega Man series. And maybe playing like Street Fighter 2 Turbo on like the hardest difficulty level. You know, back in the day, those old school games that really made me cuss and not throw a controller because those fucking things are $50 a piece. But want to throw a controller, you know. I probably haven't had that since my childhood, and this game does make me feel like a child sometimes because I have such a childlike reaction to it. Like when I die, I'm just like, fuck off, you know? And, you know, when you die, I don't know, like 5 or 6 times in the same place over and over again, and you lose. Like, there was one time I lost like 60,000 souls, and I was like, oh my God, you know, it's just, it's such a sinking feeling. But you kind of get over it, I guess. But you know, you just think of all the levels and all the items that you could replenish with all those souls, and it really you know, pisses you off. I guess that's part of the risk reward system that people find so appealing. When I'm pissed off at the game, I'm pissed off at the game, and I don't particularly like it. But then for some reason, I keep coming back. And even when I played Dark Souls 2, I would get so pissed off at the game, but I would still boot it back up to try to get past where I was. And then eventually I was just like, you know what? I want to play something else, get rid of it, done. But yeah, I mean, the game's kind of, if you play it as like a hack and slash game, you're going to die, and you're going to die a lot. You really need to pay attention to like enemy movements, enemy distance, patterns. And it's kind of memorization of the levels, like the same way that the old Mega Man games were, or Castlevania, you know, but, yeah, there's a lot of different classes to choose from. If you guys want to play as melee, you can play as melee, but I'm telling you, bows, just watching Joe play, bows are completely overpowered. Playing as a royal or a mage, you know, is probably a good way to go for new people, especially royalty, because your starting out equipment makes it really easy for you to survive. But yeah, you just kind of move through. There's 5 different arc stones. There's a 6th one that I guess they weren't able to finish because the game was rushed. But really, I couldn't imagine going through a 6th stage. That would just be, oh my God, that'd be too much. Took me about, I don't know, maybe about 38 hours to beat. But you just move through stage, and there's several bosses in each stage. And for the most part, if you play as a royal character, the bosses are ridiculously easy compared to actually getting through the stage. Like, I've had a lot harder times getting through the stage than actually beating the bosses, because they all seem really susceptible to magic. So, royalty. If you're new to the series and you're new to Demon Souls, pick royalty. I'm telling you now. And then later, you know, as you get a feel for the game, if you want to go back and play as a different class, there you go. But start out as a royalty and see what the game has to offer. But, you know, I feel like so many people have done videos about Demon Souls and Dark Souls. I don't really feel like I need to talk about the gameplay. I feel like everyone who plays video games knows about the gameplay of, you know, the Souls series. It's a very kind of slow, I don't want to say tedious, but meticulous RPG. You have to really kind of go through the stages slowly. And even after you get really strong, you still have to kind of be careful going back to earlier stages to kind of farm for souls, because enemies will just kill you really quick. I mean, you will die really quick in this game. So, that's my advice to everybody out there. It's just move through these stages relatively slow and really kind of pay attention to your surroundings. But as far as the gameplay goes, it's a very slow-paced action RPG, dungeon crawler that you will die a lot. You will see the "you died" screen a lot. So just be prepared for that. As far as the music goes, really, in a lot of ways, the music is almost never really there. It's really strange. It's really, as you're moving through the stage, it's just ambient noises that would be around you as you move through the stage. The music really, you know, is in the beginning of the game when you start it up and sort of the end credits. And then here and there, you'll get like really kind of cool pieces of like just ambient, kind of mournful, sad music. You're not going to get anything like, you know, Falcom's JDK in here. No, like, really propulsive songs. It's really kind of a sorrowful soundtrack. And it really fits the mood of the game, because you're just moving through all these really destroyed, you know, ruined areas. because this is, of course, after the old one has just come down and just laid the bitch slap down on everything. So it really makes sense that the music would be very mournful, very sorrowful, and not propulsive. You know, you're not going to get, like, metal guitars or anything in here. The voice acting, very good, but in the same respect as the music, very kind of sorrowful. These are all people that are trapped in the Nexus, which I never really talked about the Nexus, mainly because I'm a little fuzzy on the storyline aspect, but basically the Nexus is a place where people, certain people who have died in this area, can congregate and try, I guess, certain selected people, they can try to make their way out of the Nexus and out of Boletaria if they choose to, like your character does. But all these NPCs that you meet, they're all, you know, they've all basically got the shit kicked out of them by what has happened in Boletaria. So they're all kind of sad, and except for one, Bior, he kind of just laughs in your face all the time. But they're all very, you know, mournful, because again, you know, it's the end. Basically, it's the end of the world. So yeah, the audio, I feel it really, the audio really enhances the mood of the game itself. So it is really good. Graphically, the game, again, this is a 2009 game. This is an older game, so it's not going to stand up to the modern stuff, especially like the PS4 stuff. But it's very good. The problem I have with this game is the color palette. It's very drab, very brown, very dark green, very gray. It fits the mood and the atmosphere of the game, but at the same time, it's like, I don't know, you just get kind of worn out by looking at it all the time. You're just like, oh, depressing. Oh, the stage is depressing too. Oh, great, the stage is depressing and dark. So, you know, graphically, while it looks good enough, and the animations are good enough and all that, it's very fluid and stuff like that, the color palette just drags it down, and it really just makes it drab and kind of boring to look at in some respects. When I played Dark Souls 2, I was more looking at this game and then looking back at Dark Souls 2. I was more taken with Dark Souls 2, Dark Souls 2's world than I was with this one, because it was a little bit, not much, but a little bit more colorful than Demon Souls. But, you know, it fits, again, it fits the mood and the atmosphere of the game, and, you know, I don't know. You want something a little bit more flashy, you might want to go with a different game than this. But anyway, this is me eating crow. I've played the game, I enjoyed my time with it. Will I go back and play my new game plus? Probably not, because, again, all of this behind me. And most of that stuff I have played, but there's still stuff, a lot of stuff I need to play. But I finally made my way through a Souls game. And some people say this is the hardest one. Some people say it's the easiest one. I don't know. It seems very subjective as to which one is actually the hardest in the series. But I enjoyed it well enough that I'm now ready to show off the mystery game that was in my pickups video that I didn't want to show a couple videos ago, and that is, yes, I did pick up a copy of Dark Souls 1. So I enjoyed the game well enough to... I haven't actually played Dark Souls 1. I just skipped ahead to Dark Souls 2, but I enjoyed the game enough to pick up the next game in the series. Now, am I going to put this in anytime soon? Probably not, because honestly, as much as I enjoyed playing this, I need to take a break from it. I need to let my blood pressure go down a little bit. I need to play some more colorful games, some more joyful games. I need to play some shorter games, for fuck's sake. I need to put in some action games for, you know. But I did pick up Dark Souls. I do plan on giving it a shot. Joe and Danny and Steven are already talking to me about, you know, what I need to do, and preparing me for it. So I'm going to give it another shot, and if my views on the series hurt anyone's feelings out there, I do apologize, because now I do kind of see where people are coming from. I understand it better, and maybe, you know, like the description says down below, I just need to eat some crow and say, you know, I was wrong. I see what you mean now. So anyway, that is it for this video. Like I said, I will probably play Dark Souls sometime this year. I can say that. When I actually play it, I don't know. And if I do enjoy my time with Dark Souls, then that puts me in good position to pick up Dark Souls 2 again on the PS4 when it comes out, and then maybe sometime down the road look into Bloodborne. I don't know. I don't want to get too far ahead of myself. I got to get through Dark Souls first and enjoy that before I move on to anything else. So anyway, that is it for this video. This is dustinkreis saying, I was wrong about a series, and I do now I enjoy Demon Souls. I don't know. I mean, Dark Souls isn't that much different, but, I do enjoy Demon Souls, and I had a good time with it. And even though it made me want to, snap the disc in half a couple times, I persevered and pushed through it, and here I am on the other end. So anyway, that is it for this video. I've rambled on enough about this game, and I'm interested to see what the comments below will be. So I don't know. But anyway, I want to thank you guys so much for watching. Take care. I'll see you next time.